What's going on? I actually broke some stuff right before we went live, so I am fixing it. Okay, we are live on Facebook, on YouTube, and on my Facebook page. What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to another episode of the Make Money and Have Fun show. This one, big episode number 10, and I am super, super excited to have my guest, Gordon Brodecki, with me here today. A few fast things before we jump into it. First of all, I want to welcome everybody back to another episode. Thanks for being here. I'm sure most of you know the drill, but for those of you that don't, there's a couple ways to actually interact with us today. So the first really cool thing is we're going live on Facebook. We're going live on YouTube. And if you're joining us over there, you can actually drop a comment in and I can bring that comment right up on screen. So if you have a question for Gordon, or you have a question that you want to bring up, or if you just want to cheer and clap and say, hey, what's going on, you can drop that comment right down below, and we will be able to bring it right up on screen and answer that question for you, or just cheer along with you. The other second really cool thing that we can do to interact with us is I actually have VIP backstage access available to all guests. So basically, all you have to do is, if you see this number right here, 215-596-1515, that's actually my cell phone number, right? So it goes right to my cell phone, but I actually set up an automated message to go out. So if you text the word Gordon, which is my guest today, if you text Gordon to 215-596-1515, you actually will get a link to come right backstage with us, and we can bring you on camera to ask your questions live on stage, getting that VIP access to come backstage. But now, without any further ado, I need to introduce you to today's guest. So let's talk a little bit about Gordon. So Gordon Brodecki is a personal trainer. He's an author, entrepreneur, and he's a founder of Garage Fitness in Croydon, PA. He also provides instruction, motion, and support to his clientele daily using tried and true wellness strategies with over 20 years of experience. Gordon provides customized training for his clients throughout their fitness journeys, and he currently resides in Pennsylvania. So let's put a hand together for Mr. Gordon Brodecki. What's going on, man?
Well, thank you for the introduction. That was pretty intense. I like it.
Not bad, right? Not bad. We got to build up the energy here, you know?
Yeah, I love it. So I see the name of your show is the Make Money and Have Fun show, mm-hmm. right? And I'd probably do that a little bit backwards, a little different. I like to have fun first, and then the money comes. You know, then the money will come. You got to enjoy what you do. I feel like that's my life.
Yeah, yeah. That's the whole idea. You know, I realized a while ago as I was studying financial literacy. You know, for those who don't know my background, I started off in real estate investing. And real estate investing really taught me a lot about financial literacy. And the more that I learned, the more that I realized that wealth and riches really wasn't the goal. And the goal became for me to not only have the money, but have the fulfillment as well. And income is really just a form of sustainability. Income is a timeline, really. And what it does is it allows us to determine how long we can have fun for. So, you know, I know a lot of people who have a ton of fun, but no money. And the problem with that is that there's no sustainability to it. So right. I love you got to have both, like Gordon said. And, you know, just that fact that you're bridging the gap means that we are in the right place today, my man.
Yes.
I love it. So, Gordon, let me ask you a question. I ask this question to all of my guests that I bring on this show, and you can answer this however you'd like. I would just recommend giving the short version of it. What is your story?
My story on how I got started in fitness.
However you want to answer that question, my man.
When I was younger, my brother bought a weight set, and he used to work at my brother Jack. And also at the time when I was younger, I used to watch The Incredible Hulk. I used to watch all the, there's Thundercats, there's Transformers, you know what I mean? All that fun stuff.
Yeah.
And you kind of look up to the cartoons. You see you want to be like that. You see this, you become the most powerful man in the universe, He-Man, you know what I'm saying?
Sure.
So you kind of you gravitate towards that. For me, as a boy, I gravitated towards that. And I started messing around with his weights at the age of 13. And I fell in love with it. And from there, I just kept researching it. And I read the encyclopedia of Arnold's book about how to become, you know, Mr. Universe. And so I fast forward, I started getting into training myself. And then I slowly started training others just for free because they were friends of mine and were training together. I used to train with my one buddy, Bob, back in the day. We used to train when we were young, my brother, Eric. And then my dad allowed me to put a weight set in the basement. So from there, we kept going. Then years later, I decided I wanted to get my foot in the door of fitness.
Mm-hmm.
And I went to this gym, and I kept bugging the guy. I said, I want to get in fitness. And he goes, what makes you special? Your muscles, that's great. And I said, well, I have good work ethic, and I'll be here and every day. And he's, okay, come back tomorrow. I did this about 3 or 4 times. Eventually, he's like, all right, come in. I'll pay you. It was like $6-$7 an hour. Come in a little earlier. I'll pay you a little extra. And lo and behold, he would fly out to Thailand. And then I'd be taking over the gym. So I cleaned the gym. I sold memberships. And eventually, I decided I was going to start training people. That's really what I wanted to do. I wanted to do that. And it wasn't really that popular at the time. It's kind of what I was. And I decided I'm going to do that. I started training people and charging them. And one day the boss walks in from Thailand. He's like, come over here. And I'm training one of my clients. And he goes, he's like, keep doing what you're doing. Bring money to the business. And then he lets me go. And then after that, I was like, oh, this is great. Eventually that business was sold. And then I worked for another company. I did that for about 10 years. And then I worked for another company and decided, you know what? The company was selling. And I was making like minimum wage. I was making good money when I moved to the next company, commission plus hourly rate, and I'm charging what I was charging, making really good money at the age of 24, 25, maybe a little older. And then all of a sudden, I decided as I got to my 30s that I'm going to own my own business, and that's what I've been doing, Garage Fitness. I worked with my brother for about a year, and I was moved into this house that I'm in now. Right. And when I moved in, I was making minimum wage. I was like, how am I going to do this? So I had to start opening my own business. Lived with my brother for a year while I was remodeling it. Quickly, after about a year, he met his wife. And then I moved out. And so I remodeled my garage and made it Garage Fitness. And it's actually, if you want to call it Garage Fitness too, my brother actually gave me the idea jokingly. And then it became a thing. And that's how it started.
So Garage Fitness. Yeah. is your brand, and it was literally in a garage, right?
Right, exactly.
That is amazing, man. Do you still have that? Like,
yeah, I still have the garage. I have my own garage now that I remodeled. I put it in about and when I remodeled everything, it took me about a few weeks. I hadn't saved money, and I put I'm not gonna say how much, but I put a bunch of money into that garage and had
sure. Like,
out and everything else. Yeah.
I bet. So it's actually funny because, like, you hear the stories of, like, you know, Apple got started in a garage. You know, I got Alex Stern, the founder of Constant Contact. He actually started in an attic instead of a garage, you know, or instead of a basement and stuff like that. And your business started in a garage, and it's still in a garage.
Yeah. Well, there's the lack of there's no overhead, really, other than everything else. And it's really good at these times with the pandemic and everything. Mm-hmm. Where it's like a one-on-one aspect that I think that actually is coming back now because people don't want to be around a lot of people. People are want a clean environment. I keep it clean before, after, wipe everything down.
Sure.
Make sure that anybody that comes doesn't have anything going on. So that's where it was with that. So that's what really is good with that.
Yeah. It makes a lot of sense. I started off as a martial arts instructor, so I was semi in the fitness world. I wasn't a personal trainer like yourself, and not really much of a gym rat myself. But I remember that one of the things that was often an objection for people, either in a martial arts class or even in a gym, is that they were self-conscious about having other people there, right? Other people seeing them, other people seeing them work out. They just have this self-consciousness about it, and I think that Garage Fitness really solves that problem. You know, it really kind of gets them over that their own barrier in their head. Do you kind of see that as a thing as well?
Yeah, most definitely. I agree with that too. Yeah, definitely gets over the barrier.
Absolutely, absolutely. So how did it kind of evolve from there? You're still taking clients in your garage now, or what is it like?
I'm booked. I'm booked solid, and I just a new client the other day, and I. Yeah, just to give you an example, I'm not going to say how many clients I have, but I can tell you I'm at least putting in 50 hours of training a week or more.
Wow. Amazing.
It's building up. It's just keeps growing, and I love it. I had some ideas in the works, but I'm not going to talk about it yet. There's some things I want to work on. Maybe
Got to get that NDA first, right?
yeah, I got some ideas.
Exactly. I love that. So I guess you're kind of, in a sense, screwed now, because going forward, you have to buy houses that have garages on them, right?
That's an idea. You're giving me some ideas here. I'm going to expand that. You'll see in the future.
Yeah. I know that. I don't know your idea, but I want to share something with you. So the Gracies are the people who brought jiu-jitsu to America. And again, I don't want to make it about martial arts. But they have these things called Gracie Garages. And basically it's this idea that students of the Gracie Academy can open up their own school inside of their garage, in a sense.
Exactly. So, that's where my head's going.
So I think we're on the same frequency here. But
I'll give a little bit of insight, but I want to help other entrepreneurs who are in the business be able to develop something like I did and create an income and a living, more than a living. And, you know, you can make a really good living.
Sure. Sure. I think it's actually funny that Gordon and I were chatting before this show, and we were talking about, like, behind the scenes of everything. So, like, for instance, right now I got this big background going on, but let me take my background off just so you can see. So this is literally what it looks like behind me. I'm just sitting in front of a curtain in a messy basement with construction going on upstairs. So it's literally, like, In the beginning stages, you're just doing whatever it takes to make it work. But you know, when you're having fun, it makes it that much different, right, Gordon?
Yes, and you made a really good point. And a lot of people, this is a great segue. A lot of people want to wait till they feel good to start doing what they have to do to start their business or whatever it is. If whatever they're trying to accomplish in life, like just get up and do anything, like. You know, work out, you know, clean a house, buy a house, whatever it is.
Right.
The problem with that model is wait until you feel good. Is you may do it, you may not do it. You might feel good for a little bit. And then when you don't feel good, you don't do it. Well, yeah, but the best way I've learned how to do it is to take a head on and do it first. And what happens is what you'll notice is a funny thing really happens, starts happening. You start building up confidence. And it starts building from there, and then you just start doing a little bit more, and then you feel good doing the stuff that's hard work, being uncomfortable, and then the hard stuff, doing the hard stuff to make, and then the good feelings start coming in. If you wait to feel good, I'm going to tell everybody out there, it's most likely not going to happen.
Yeah. You need to create your own good feeling, in a sense. We used to say that motion creates emotion.
Yes.
Right? Once you start moving, you start feeling good. Your blood gets pumping and all that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
So we actually got, it looks like another Brodecki jumping in here. John Brodecki, is that a father, brother, cousin?
My brother. He's the one who actually had the weight set in the basement.
Oh, that's so funny.
Franchise's business model. That is a plan. That is a plan. We'll see where that goes.
Everybody wants you to spill the beans on this show. What are they doing here?
So, the whole idea is to set it up like a franchise. I don't want to dive too much into it, but like Tony Robbins talks about it. He's like, set it up like a franchise, regardless if you sell it or not. That way, if you do get to that point, you have a business model that you have an extra strategy on and everything else with.
Exactly. So I'm actually going to segue us a little bit, so we can keep everything under wraps, and we'll do a follow-up show in like 6 months, and you can tell us, you know, how your business has boomed and all that kind of stuff.
Pressure's on now.
But you're actually transitioning right now a little bit, right? You're moving into more of the speaker and author space, right?
Yes, which I really enjoy. what's funny is years ago when I was at, I used to work at a gym called Ballytoe Fitness. I'll tell you where I used to work at. And worked there for over 10 years. That's the gym I worked at. And I was telling a client one day, and I kept thinking about, I'm going to write a book someday, right? I just said, out of nowhere, I said I wanted to write a book. And I had all these ideas. And at first, I wanted to be like a tutorial of how to do things. But I noticed as it evolved over time, that it totally shifted. My mindset shifted. And I realized it's not about just counting numbers and setting somebody up in a routine. It's about changing the whole mindset and so they can stick with a routine that they can do for life.
Exactly.
And like if I would talk a little bit about that, I would say like a lot of people want to join the gym or work out because they want to feel sexier, they want to be happier, they know it's good for them, they know all the good things, but it's hard for they have the toughest time staying on a routine. Now, if I get not to go off too off track, but a lot of people who start a diet and lose weight. There's a guy I follow, Lane Norton, Dr. Lane Norton, who actually, like, his stuff is great for anybody who wants to listen to him. He has a lot of science behind it. But he talks about within the first year, after somebody loses weight, 75% of people gain their weight back. 2 years, 85%, and 95% after 3 years. Now, why is that? Why are everybody the people that follow these diets and get on this program and lose weight, feel good, all of a sudden 3 years gain all the weight back and then some? Well, that's here. That's the mindset. The mindset that hasn't shifted yet. It has shifted to realize that this is a lifestyle and this is what you're going to have to do for life. And people have to navigate through that. That's why I tell people, I do the same thing. Hire a coach. Hire somebody. Find somebody. Find mentors. Find groups of people that can hold you accountable. I talk a lot about that in my book about being held accountable, because being held accountable is huge. A lot of people don't get that.
I love that. That resonates with me so much. I mean, the first book that I ever wrote was all on mindset. And I believe that mindset, like you said, mindset is the foundation. That needs to be laid before anything else. So I'm actually going to do something fun here. So think of a pyramid. So for those of you watching, I just changed my background to a pyramid. Pyramids come to a point, right? But if you notice the bottom, everything's backwards on here. The bottom of the pyramid is much larger than the top of the pyramid. And the reason for that is because you need a strong foundation, a strong base to hold everything up with. And so starting with mindset, I absolutely love that. Another thing that I really love about this book, Gordon, I love the title. The title of this book is amazing. Unleash the Ultimate You.
Yeah. Yeah.
So cool, man.
Funny about that title, it was like a subtitle when I originally was writing it. It was like 10 fitness tips and leash. And I was like, you know what? No, it's unleash ultimate. You change your mindset, change your body. And the reason I said unleash ultimate you is because the reason behind that title is everybody's different. Everybody's ultimate version of themselves is different. So now I Arnold Schwarzenegger, and then you have somebody who just wants to get up and move. Their ultimate version of themselves is the better version of themselves than it was yesterday or today. That is the unleash ultimate you. That's what it's really about. That's the core. It's not about, oh, we're going to be like these Olympic athletes and we're going to be all like super muscular, super ripped and super jacked. No, it's not about that. It's about becoming the best version of yourself and who you want to be. And if that can resonate with a lot of people, that's why I really want to bring across with that, at least ultimate you. Not the ultimate, you know, Joneses, you.
Yeah. No, I love that. Because like you said, some people, their goal could be just to be able to touch their toes. Other people, it's like, I want to be, you know, a gold medal Mr. Olympia. You know, so it's like you got these goals all across the board. And I think that it makes perfect sense.
Yeah.
So, Gordon, I have a picture of the cover. Are we okay with showing that off a little bit?
Yeah, show it off.
Sure. So this is actually the cover. Actually, let me see if I can make it bigger. I'm going to give you a bigger version of it.
I have the book right here if you want to see the cover.
Oh, boom, there it is.
Better. I love it.
The Ultimate You. This is such a cool book, such a cool title, such a cool cover. Oh man, I literally love everything about this. As you know, I'm an author myself. And so to Wyatt is still here. Go away. Oh, it's because I'm clicking on the wrong one. There it is. So to have somebody else who's an author like that, you're a first-time author too, right?
Yes.
Awesome, yeah. Man. Tell us about the launch. When's it coming out? How can we get our hands on it?
It's out now. It's out now. It's out now. The book is out now. go on Amazon and find the book, right? Elise Schultz, you. And you can either you type my name in or you can type the book's name in and you'll find it. It'll pop right up. It's already doing really well. I'm getting a good response. You know what? And I get there's something I'm going to talk about. I wanted to touch base on. A lot of people say, like, I got a lot of haters out there, and I'm going to show all the haters. I don't know if it's just me, but I don't really feel like I mean, if I do, maybe it's my perspective. I don't feel like I have a lot of support out there. I have a lot of people, and I'm like, wow, they're like, you know, congratulations, thank you, and this, and I'm like, wow, I don't see. And if I do have haters, I don't see them. Maybe it's my perspective on things, but I just really appreciate everybody out there who's been supporting me, and I really, really love it. I want to thank everybody out there who has purchased the book and who has even just thanked me and congratulated me. And on the show, too, everybody loves it that I'm being on Fred's show today.
I love it, man, dude. I'm super pumped to have you on here. This is already one of my favorite shows. I mean, it's so cool because for me, I always look at the link like you do between your mindset and your physical fitness. You know, like I said, I started off in the martial arts world, which is very, very much shrouded in fitness. You know, it's not so much weightlifting and that kind of stuff, but it's definitely something where people need to overcome themselves. I feel like because we have these limiting beliefs and these patterns and these habits that we live through. And then they do something like they join a gym or they join a martial arts school or some sort of activity, yoga, whatever it might be. And the first thing they need to do is they need to get out of their own way.
Right.
And really, I think that's what you're showing people how to do.
Exactly. I mean, yeah, I don't know if you knew I was in martial arts when I was younger, Taekwondo.
Cool.
At a club around here. And then I worked with a couple other people. I had a good friend, Eric Purcell, who I'll throw some shout-outs to the NPR, and a good friend, Adam Olson, who taught me some jiu-jitsu at Adam Olson Fitness. Some really good guys out there that are in the industry. I have a good friend, Adam Harris, that does the training, Dan Campos. A lot of good trainers out there. There's a lot of good people can see, not just me. And I always tell everybody, like, spread the word. Like, I'm not – one thing I want to tell people is in any business, at least for me, this is how I do it. Is it isn't like steal from somebody, rob somebody. It's like everybody can have a piece of the pie in the business. It's not like take from somebody else. It's, hey, look at this person. They're doing well. Like pat them on the back, pat each other on the shoulders, man. Reach out to each other, give each other shout outs. That's what it's about.
Exactly. Exactly. That's how I've been able to have so many amazing people on this show is just because, you know, I treat every relationship like it's a piece of gold. You know, it's the most valuable commodity out there, and relationships are a currency. And when you do that, when you look at it from a place of abundance instead of a place of lack, like you said, you realize that there's a piece of the pie for everybody.
Right.
You know, if you're just given that value, it comes back to you at that point.
Exactly. I was talking to a good friend of mine, Bobby. Her name's Bobby Clark, and she's going to start her own business too soon. And she was just talking to me, and I was just coaching her to do some things, and she's learned some of the logistics part, because that's not the fun part, right?
Yeah.
You know, behind the scenes part. All the, like, you know, like, so we had a good conversation on that, and soon she'll be open. And I told her, we had the same conversation. Everybody gets to pat each other on the back. Nobody, it's not about taking from this person or taking from that. It's about giving to each other. Like if I don't have somebody in somewhere I live, I say, hey, this person, go to this person, or try this person out. This might fit your personality better, you know?
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, the internet is eliminating geography today, but I always do that. I always, you know, I have people that come to me and say, hey, I'm looking for X, Y, and Z. And I always tell people two things. I'm like, look, either I have the answer for you or I know who does.
Yeah.
And, you know, sometimes I'm just referring people to somebody else. You know, if somebody came to me wanting to learn how to, you know, wanting to get, you know, personal training, I'd send them to you. I'd be like, yeah, go talk to Gordon, you know, or yeah, whatever.
Right.
You know, different stuff like that. So it's always
in the beginning, I think I'm going to touch base on the business aspect. A lot of people try to wear too many hats, right? Mm-hmm. People, like, they pride themselves on, like helping everybody out. But the problem with that business model is that that you're gonna spread yourself thin. So find what really works for you. If I can give any advice on people who are open to gym, that find your niche, whatever that niche might be. And it might not happen right away. Just keep working on it and fine tuning it.
Exactly. So Gordon, we got about 5 minutes left. What do you want to leave our guests with? What's your message to everybody here who's watching us today?
Well, I kind of touched base on it a little bit already, and it was about being the best version of yourself and limiting belief. So a lot of people have limiting beliefs, and what I mean by that is the word can't comes into play a lot, and that's a real easy thing to say for us because we think a lot more negative thoughts than we do positive thoughts. Like probably 75% of our thoughts are negative throughout the day. To switch that narrative, you got to start saying things to yourself. You have to start talking to yourself a little bit more, have self-talk about how you want to live your life. And if you want to live your life in a place of being negative, it's most likely if you keep telling yourself the same stories over and over again, it's not going to change. If you want to change who you are in the core, you got to repeat to yourself constant positive thoughts. And regardless, if it doesn't feel comfortable, it's not going to feel comfortable at first because the comfortability level is the negative part that you're so used to. Why would you want to change? And so you're so used to that. It's like, oh, that feels comfortable. You fall back into old patterns. So to change new patterns, you got to keep doing the things that feel uncomfortable. And that's when you start growing. And then you realize, oh, I actually really enjoy this. This is actually, then you start enjoying it. And that's the whole thing I was talking about earlier, is you got to do first, the good feelings come second. Not the good feelings come, and then because you'll keep going down that negative. And it's hard to tell people that because they're stuck in that pattern. And until they start experiencing it, like I have, then they can sort of feel that. And I'm not saying that you won't fall back into some bad patterns. I definitely do. Human being. Everybody's saying it's not easy. It's not easy. It's a lot of work. Meditation, journaling, getting up earlier. Like today, I slept in. And guess what? I woke up at 7:30 a.m. today. That was sleeping in for me. Like I get up at like 5 in the morning now, sometimes earlier, because some people want to come and train at 5 a.m. in the morning. So that's probably like mostly every day. And today was like a treat. So I slept in, didn't do any meditation, didn't do anything.
I wonder how many people on here would consider waking up at 7:30 as sleeping in.
Well, at one point, that was early for me. I hate waking up early, but that was my limiting belief. I was like, oh, I can't do that. It's too early. You know, I didn't want to. Why would I go? And it's like you start shifting your mindset. You start shifting your lifestyle. I don't know if that comes with age. It definitely comes with time because you have to reflect on that kind of stuff. Then you start growing into a different direction.
Oh, man, I love this. This is actually turning out to be a better interview than I had anticipated. You know, I thought it was going to be awful. No, I'm just kidding.
Great time. I love it.
It's funny because I've only met you about two or three other times. And, we met at events. So we kind of didn't have a ton of time to really get to know each other, I feel like, because we were either speaking or we were working or whatever.
Yeah. Kind of thing. But, you guys were schooling, Larry Steinhouse and Fulton Cone, and the great guys. And actually, I've been talking to his son, Stone Falcone, and he's a really good guy. And the whole staff is great.
Yeah. I mean, it's the circles that you run in. You know, it's that old cliche that, you are the sum of your five closest friends. And I like to change that and just say, if you have four rich friends, you're the fifth.
Yeah.
So it's been this interesting thing where I've been looking and I'm like, man, Gordon's trying to be a speaker. He's writing this book. He's got all this cool stuff going on, which, by the way, you got to pick up his book on Amazon. Head over to that link. I'm buying it right after this show ends. And, make sure you grab a copy of Gordon's book, because if you think this stuff is awesome, I can't even wait to hear what he writes about in his book. I'm super pumped and super excited for that. And I want to support him in every way. It's been so cool just to get inside your mind, man, and see kind of what your philosophy on life is and how everything looks for you. It's been a blast.
Thank you. Yeah, I could talk for hours, as you can tell. I do have a lot of fun doing this kind of stuff, so I want to, I'm looking forward to if birds of a feather flock. Yeah, we do, Jack. He calls himself John, but we call him Jack.
You've been our commenter of the day, John. Thanks for being here. If anybody else wants to comment, give us some comments. Exactly. Give us some. Is he like sitting behind you on the other side of the computer?
Oh, no, he's not. He's at work, actually. He actually works for a living.
That's funny. I love it, man. So, yeah, this has been a blast, man. I'm super pumped to have you here, and you know, keyword being pumped since we're talking about personal training. But yeah, man, I'm having a blast. I'm so glad that you were here, and let's say goodbye to all of our guests, man. We got a whole bunch of people hanging out here.
There's a lot of people. I can't see every today, but
I got seven people, actually eight people viewing us now, and then, you know, it depends on how many people are on YouTube right now. We got John sending in all kinds of content. Comments. He said it's his lunchtime. John, what are you having for lunch?
Protein. He lost a lot of weight recently. He's doing really great. Good working out. A friend of mine used to work with Adam Harris, so he's doing really good. I love it.
I love that. Well, on that note, you guys know the drill. We're signing off for this time. Until next time, we'll see everybody next week. Thanks a lot, Gordon.
All right, thank you. See you, friend.
Right. Have a good one, man.
Thank you.